Gildan Media, a division of Recorded Books, presents Scale or Fail, How to Build Your Dream Team, Explode Your Growth, and Let Your Business Soar by Allison Maslan. Narrated by Allison Maslan. You may find related worksheets at scaleorfail.com/bonus. Dedicated to you, the enterprising entrepreneur whose gifts the world needs. May this book give you the wings to fly. Fearlessness is like a muscle. I know from my own life that the more I exercise it, the more natural it becomes to not let my fears run me. The first time we take that first fearless step, we begin to change our lives. And the more we act on our dreams and our desires, the more fearless we become. Arianna Huffington. Make decisions from where you're going, not from where you're at. Allison Maslan. How this book is different. There are many books available that share and teach principles that will help you grow or scale your company. Often the listener completes one of these books feeling inspired and motivated, but then becomes perplexed on what steps to actually take to reach their goals and how to apply them to their own business. What sets Scale or Fail apart is that I'm not merely sharing my philosophy with you on how you can scale your business. In this book, I also teach you step by step how to utilize the Scale It method to fast track your success, growth, and profits. It's easy to follow, workable, and so valuable. You are not simply holding in your hands a book that offers great insights. You are about to hear a complete signature program that will transform your company beyond your wildest dreams. Foreword. When you first meet Allison, you get the sense that she's done impossible things. This feeling is not easily articulated. It is an unspoken energy that surrounds her. It is an invisible, powerful force that comes through in such a gentle way that you want to take on the hardship of scaling. She has a way with it, and she teaches you not only how to scale, but also how to scale over and over again. You see, she takes that invisible force and gives it to you. At first, she makes you feel that it is easy to do, that it is possible for you to overcome all the pain, all the fear, all the uncertainty. You even forget that scaling is daunting. This is how it felt when I first met her in 2011. I was just starting out with my life reentry work, and she grabbed my hand and said, "Christina, this will be hard, but you can do this." I remember thinking, I know what hard is. This can't be harder than loss. After all, I had lost my husband and had gone through some impossible things. But she was right. It was close. Scaling is brutal. It's not for the faint of heart. It is as painful and as impossible as the hardest things in life. It requires something, a very important something, resilience to pain. You have an opponent every day when you wake up. Your opponent is called struggle. You have to fight with struggle every day, and in the end, you must win. Somehow, Allison has won tens of thousands of these battles with her gentle fierceness. She built 10 businesses and has held the hand of so many, like myself, who were starting out and showed them what is possible. I know you want to change the world. I know you have a dream, a mission, a fire inside of you that wants to create, grow, and scale it to reach millions of people. Will you have the right book in your hands to help you make this a reality? It doesn't matter what business you are in. You may have created a hair salon because of the way you believe women should feel about themselves, or you have a grocery store that influences the gut health of your customers and you want one in every corner. Maybe you own an engineering company that is ready to innovate your industry, or a construction company with a big vision to transform the way we live. This book is made for you. I have to be honest with you, scaling your dream is almost impossible. Most of the time, the safety net is non-existent. Nothing is underneath you to catch you, and this is why Allison wrote this book. She built you a net to catch you when you fall. She's here to ensure that you scale and not fail. I will never forget the day I spent with Allison at her office many years ago. She stood in front of me with a big black marker and a whiteboard and showed me what my work could do for the world. She found the proof I was missing when my struggles and fears would wake me up in the morning waiting for the battle. I saw the vision of what was possible for the first time. In Allison's fashion, she made it seem simple, easy, doable, and you know what else? Fun. I realized then that the invisible force that surrounded Allison was her ability to have fun even when scaling and doing impossible things. Her vibe, her spirit, and her essence came from her flying in her trapeze every week, no matter how hard her days had been. She has taught herself to fly even on the days that she was falling, maybe even especially on those days. As I read this book, I realize that she took all of her flying experience and made it into words so that you too could tap into this invisible force as you find your way to scaling your big dream. As for me, the vision Allison wrote on that whiteboard has come true tenfold. When you listen to this book and you apply her formula, your vision will become a bigger and brighter reality than you ever thought possible. Enjoy the flying, the scaling, and changing the world. I am. Christina Rasmussen, founder of Life Reentry Institute and best-selling author of Second Firsts, Live, Laugh, and Love Again. Introduction. Oh, what if I fall? Oh, but my darling, what if you fly? Aaron Hansen, young poet. Scaling a business has many similarities to swinging on the flying trapeze. I should know, as an adult, I have learned to do both. On the trapeze, you must climb a 35-foot ladder to reach the top. Yes, it can be terrifying, but just like growing your business, you must be willing to take many fearful risks in order to achieve your goals. Once you make it up the ladder, you are standing on a platform that's only a few feet wide. It's nerve-wracking and, to some people, paralyzing. People often allow their fear or lack of direction to hold them back, and they're not willing to take the leap. It is exactly the same in business when you are poised to expand and scale. You have two choices at this point. One, you can gather your courage and break through to where all the riches are waiting. This experience is exhilarating, enriching, and tremendously rewarding. Or two, you can get stuck on the platform and tell yourself every reason why scaling is not a good idea. In this scenario, you go nowhere. What will you choose to do? I chose the first option, though it took some time to get there. I started my first business in college, and by the age of 25, I was already running my own national advertising and public relations firm. My clients included Fortune 100 companies such as Supercuts, Ben & Jerry's, and Charlotte Russe. I was making great money, but I was working night and day. I should have been on top of the world, but I had no life of my own, and honestly, I felt miserable. I recognized that my business needed a new model to continue its growth beyond my own individual efforts, but I didn't know how. Years later, after a powerful wake-up call resulting from a near-fatal car accident and a failing marriage, I made a life-changing decision to walk away from the lucrative agency that was starving my soul and figure out how to get there, whatever that ultimately was going to mean. The result was that I developed an innovative method of scaling that led to a much more impactful and meaningful business path, both personally and monetarily. I took a risk and have never looked back. Instead, I've moved forward to achieve even greater success through building and scaling 9 additional businesses, generating millions of dollars. It is of even greater personal importance to me that along the way, I've developed a business mentoring company that has helped thousands of other business owners around the world realize their full potential. As many of us know and have already experienced, dreams can easily get shattered. If you are among the few who haven't yet, trust me when I say that you will. As you'll discover in this book, setbacks and failure are not a bad thing. Expectations sometimes need flexibility, a willingness to look at a challenge from a new set of eyes. Starting out with an innovative idea, seed money, hard work, hope, and confidence-building pep talks are all great assets, but they are certainly not guarantees for success. There are a great many variables affecting whether you and your business reach their full potential. Growing your business is an even more daunting endeavor. You've made it through the early stages. You've built a client base. You've established some product recognition. You've seen some decent results. And maybe you've even managed to keep your cash flow somewhat consistent. But soon you find that the business is leveling off. Costs are rising. In order to achieve your long-term financial goals, you know you need to expand existing revenue streams or create new ones, or your company will stagnate and then sink. On the other hand, such expansion involves risk. As a rabbi once said to me when I was discussing the pains of my marriage at the time, nothing worth having is ever easy. However, there are ways that you can stack the odds heavily in your favor. The scaling model described in this book, which has guided the success of many of my clients, is a practical, proactive approach that can also help you shift your risk-reward equation. You have nothing to lose except a few hours invested in listening to this book and applying its methodology. What is scaling exactly? When founders reach a certain point at which they feel as if they are chasing their tails and putting out fires, have unending to-do lists, and never have any free time, it becomes impossible for them to focus on the things that can actually grow their businesses. They've had success with their companies and with building revenue, but they just can't seem to make the jump to the next level or even hire the right people. It drives them nuts, taking all the wind out of their sails, pun intended, and the fun out of their lives. So what does the word scaling mean for those founders, perhaps this group includes you, who can't seem to get to that elusive next level? I like to think of this in terms of being able to grow your business while at the same time managing the expanding workload without sacrificing your level of performance, efficiency, and employee safety. In fact, if you are scaling properly, you are creating processes and workflows that improve all areas of your operation and save you a lot of time, money, and headaches. By adopting a scalable business model, you can generate huge profits without all the budgetary strains that overburden traditional growth models. The goal of scaling is to build a replicable system for delivering products and services that allow businesses to increase their customer base without having to increase their overhead at the same pace. The traditional growth model has fostered a vicious cycle of inefficiency, causing companies to hit a wall that they cannot break through. For instance, a company gains a few new clients, so they hire more people to service those clients, adding costs at nearly the same rate that they're adding revenue. The method in this book will show you how to grow, replicate, and expand while at the same time building a self-managed company that you can step away from for periods of time as it continues to soar. Most Fortune 500 companies are structured in a way that allows the CEOs to come and go without impacting the company's success. This is a mere dream for most business owners. But in this book, I'm going to show you exactly how it can become your reality. To me, successful scaling means that you get to a point in your business where you are flying higher with less effort and resistance. Like a professional trapeze artist who creates more height, power, and momentum when he allows the physics of his leap, swing, and team to carry him to new heights. Let me explain how this concept works. Scaling away with the greatest of ease. Let's start with a story to illustrate my philosophy of scaling and how I find a great metaphor in the exhilarating world of trapeze artistry. Years ago, when I was at a crossroads in my life, I happened upon the Flying Gionas, a fifth-generation family of trapeze artists who performed with circuses such as the Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus and the Big Apple Circus. Richie Giona, a legendary trapeze artist himself, operates a training facility called Giona's Trapeze Workshop, where people from all over the globe are trained to fly. Now, having been a gymnast back in high school, I became exhilarated at the prospect of trying out this physical and seemingly dangerous art form. I simply had to try this out for myself and take the leap, as it were. From that very first leap, I was hooked. More than 18 years later, and still going strong, I continue to climb up that 35-foot ladder to a narrow pedestal and stretch out into the air. In my mind, I visualize the routine ahead of me, as well as my safe landing, sometimes reciting to myself the lyrics from the song, "The Daring Young Man on the Flying Trapeze." Probably the most famous circus song ever, and written as a tribute to the real-life 19th-century French trapeze artist Jules Léotard. Below, a team of flyers and spectators watch with anticipation as I inch my toes to the edge of the platform. I draw in and release a deep breath, and in an instant later, jump into mid-air. I somersault once, then twice. That is the plan, and with the goal of just the right timing and finesse, clasp my arms gracefully with those of another trapeze artist who is appropriately known as the catcher. And because a trapeze artist should always seek to take her aerial feats to the next level, I repeat all of this motion again, only this time with a jump that is higher up, a swing with more drive, or an additional twist to push myself beyond what I thought I was capable of achieving. The goal in business and trapeze arts is to surpass what your mind wants you to believe you can accomplish while assembling the systems, processes, and team behind you so that you can soar. Like any team sport, it is the union of the individual's determination, persistence, and finesse intertwined with the right strategies and team to propel from. Okay, my feet are now firmly back on earth. You are no doubt still wondering, what does all of this have to do with scaling? As it turns out, scaling a business shares a similar process to swinging on a trapeze, although, of course, it's all planted on the ground. Playing it safe isn't a business strategy. As a business person, you must develop a clear vision, stretch yourself into uncharted territories, and sync gracefully with the right team. In both instances, tremendous amounts of fear are typically involved. Because the scaling process and fear of the unknown and or failure are so daunting and scary, business owners are often unwilling to take the leaps necessary to take their businesses to the next level and grow. And yet, calculated risk-taking is an essential part of success, which means that avoiding the scaling process due to fear of failure will completely paralyze and stagnate your business. This book is less about the prudence of weighing risk and reward, which to be sure is just plain smart to do, and more about failure caused by surrendering to the irrational fears, disorganized thought processes, and blindness to life-changing opportunities in favor of the status quo. Avoiding danger is no safer in the long run than outright exposure. The fearful are caught as often as the bold. Helen Keller, author, activist, and lecturer. Consider the statistics. The play-it-safe mindset leads 34 million American business owners to avoid risk entirely and suffer from smallness. But what these business owners don't realize is that playing it safe leads to unsafe results, missed opportunities, inability to meet demand, lost market share, flat to declining performance, employee unrest and turnover, or a business that could have been and would have been, yet never made the full commitment to fly, so to speak. These titans flopped big time. The great entrepreneurs know that it takes an iron stomach to succeed in business. You must learn from your mistakes, many of them extremely painful, before you can reboot, recharge your courage, and expend your time, energy, and more often than not, invest what little remains of your savings. What I knew to be true is that my biggest turnarounds and upswings came when I hit a wall hard. And I was forced to look at the situation creatively with a new set of eyes and devise an innovative solution to not only recover, but to ultimately fly high rather than remain stuck. For a moment, consider these four megaflops: an online auction site, a cutting-edge computer, a fried chicken recipe that was rejected some 1,000 times, and a soda product to compete with Coke and Pepsi. Would you ever guess that, in order, these epic flops were from Jeff Bezos, Z Shops, Steve Jobs, Next Computers, Colonel Sanders, KFC Chicken before it finally clicked, and Richard Branson, Virgin Cola? I would say that these four all overcame their fears and failures to land just a bit of success, wouldn't you? They persevered regardless of their setbacks. Lesson: never, ever allow a no or a flop to stop you. Even if such extreme outcomes don't occur, the worst feeling from any entrepreneur is to settle on a shrinking vision. Whether you are a fledgling or you've been chipping away at it for many years, chances are you came to this book because you began with big dreams and you continue to hold on tight to them. You want to stretch yourself, grow, and soar through the air like a trapeze artist. I relate to all of this because I used to be one of the many entrepreneurs, perhaps like you at this moment, who was frustrated because I was stuck in overwhelmed mode. Things changed only when I began to stretch myself beyond what I had thought were my limitations. Channeling the same self-assurance I had when I leapt off the platform to catch the trapeze bar with my hands, I catapulted from being a small-time entrepreneur to the leader of a thriving enterprise. Okay, I've launched my business. Now what? When I was a struggling single mom, I had to get honest real fast about my illusions that I had a business safety net. Instead, I embraced the idea of transforming from an underdog small business owner to a powerhouse CEO. I was not savvy by any means in those early days, but I was smart enough to know what I did not know. I realized that if I was going to fly into the unknown, I needed to surround myself with experts who had walked the walk before me. Just as I had found a top trapeze coach to help instruct and guide me to successfully fulfill that passion, I recognized I needed to do the same for my business. Looking back, finding the right advisors who had been there, done that, and could give it to me straight was the best strategic move I ever made towards finding long-term success. It's possible you've heard this advice before in some form or another. In fact, you can find a lot of excellent advice if you're in startup mode or in the early stages of owning a business. But there isn't as much help available once your business is off the ground. You may even feel like a forgotten entrepreneur trying to figure it all out on your own and ask yourself, I made it here, but how the heck do I get there? What I have found from my own personal experience in building 10 successful companies over 3 decades, each one started from scratch and scaled up, and from sharing my process with thousands of business owners, is that there exists a certain place no one tells you about as you're growing your company. In fact, you may not even recognize you are there until you've been stuck for some time. Entering another dimension. This vast nowhere land resides somewhere in the void between entrepreneur and enterprise. I liken it to the Twilight Zone TV show, except in this case, it's where so many small business owners inexplicably get lost and stagnant. To quote a line from the opening monologue of the classic TV series, it lies between the pit of man's fears and the summit of his knowledge. There was nothing in the dark that wasn't there when the lights were on. Rod Serling, screenwriter, playwright, and narrator of The Twilight Zone. Once you've crossed into the entrepreneurial twilight zone, you struggle to find your way out and think you're trapped there forever while fumbling through trying to build an enterprise. After many failed attempts, landing you right back where you started, you start to feel like the little engine that could from the children's book. When you ride on flat and steady land, you're cruising along. But when you hit the steep hills, you find you need a lot more horsepower, direction, and support in order to reach the top. You have shifted into playing a much bigger game with more pressure and greater responsibility, and it takes so much more resilience and fortitude to obtain a win. As in the little engine story, you hear your inner voice chant, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can. Wait a minute, the voice says to you. I don't think I can. I need larger wheels, a stronger engine, and more oomph to keep up with those bigger trains and make it through the entire journey. You really want to get up that hill, that is, grow your business, but nothing you did starting out as an early entrepreneur seems to be working anymore, even when you pressed yourself harder. In all likelihood, you have your hands in every part of the business, wearing way too many hats in an effort to maintain control. Meanwhile, you are continuing to implement the same old strategies, management practices, and mindset that you used in the early days, which will not work as you get further along on your climb. I'll use another classic children's story to illustrate my point. Do you remember in Lewis Carroll's classic Alice in Wonderland when Alice blew up like a giant in the White Rabbit's tiny house with her arms and legs flailing through the doors and windows? When she was smaller, she fit just fine in the little house. Now that she has grown, she is busting out at the seams. Apply that image to your business situation, and you can see why things that used to work before have all of a sudden stopped functioning as expected. Products or services that used to sell are no longer selling. Systems that used to keep you in check are breaking down. Important tasks are slipping through the cracks, and you are running around like a crazy person trying to hold it all together. And you're realizing that some of the employees who helped you so much in the beginning don't have the skills or fortitude to take you to the next level. Here's the thing. You can't build a bigger house upon the same foundation and beams as those of your smaller house. Similarly, you can't double or triple your company's revenue with the same bandwidth, thought processes, tools, and materials you used when you started. Amazon.com, Apple, Google, and even Disney all originated in garages years ago and have long since outgrown them. Imagine if they'd never left their garages. What do you think would have happened? Sticking to old habits is a recipe to fail, not scale. And they are no way to live your life, much less run a company. That said, it is understandable why so many business owners keep banging their heads against a wall to figure out how to get to the next level while refusing to try anything new or different. We take action based on what we know and what we have done before, as if the past can predict the future. Certainly, there is a lot to be learned from prior experience. However, as is the case when it comes to most habits, it is often not about having learned with an eye towards enrichment, but rather from unconscious programming that is far removed from any informed decision-making. Obvious examples of this occur all the time in everyday life, and you don't even realize it. How many times have you not consumed enough water during exercise and then felt dehydrated? Or how many times have you stayed up late to get work done and then were ragged and red-eyed for an important meeting the next day? Letting go of what you know. In order to recondition your mind with new choices for expansion while you are in the twilight zone, chugging up the hill and shedding your old business model, you must be willing to get out of the comfort zone and let go of everything you've been doing. Just as a trapeze artist must step off the platform and venture into the unknown with a completely different mindset than the one she had while her feet were on the ground, you must also clear your mind before stepping into uncharted territory. Yes, of course, you should value your life experience and be proud of your acquired wisdom. At the same time, however, you need to be honest with yourself and realize that some of those things might also be holding you back from springboarding to reach your fullest potential. To begin, ask yourself these important questions. Am I playing big enough? Do I look at my business as a way to change the world? How big of an impact do I want to make? Maybe you've heard or read about businesses that skyrocket from $500,000 to $100 million in what seems like record speed. The truth is, in most cases, these companies underwent years of strategic planning and blood, sweat, and tears prior to experiencing this astronomical growth. You didn't hear about their grassroots rev up before their scale up. No doubt you were also unaware there were common philosophies, practices, and systems in play among these success stories that helped them overcome their fears, break free from their stagnant thinking, change their limiting habits, and navigate other bumps in the road while they scaled. The fastest growing companies. In 2017, Fortune announced its annual list of 100 fastest companies. What is most striking about this list is that 7 out of the top 10 began as startups created by one or two people, and then over the years, seemingly overnight, found a way to scale to ginormous proportions through a wide range of means, sometimes via investment capital and a company sale or merger. Many of them have sustained and prospered while weathering all kinds of storms over the years, only to come out on top. In most cases, the original founders, such as Mark Zuckerberg and Jeff Bezos, have famously, or infamously, depending on your point of view, continued to maintain control over their mega businesses. Among these remarkable success stories, LendingTree, launched in 1996 by Doug Lebda at number 3, a biomed founded by David M. Letterman in 1981 as Applied Biomedical Corporation at number 4, Facebook, founded by Mark Zuckerberg and Eduardo Saverin in 2004 at number 6, NetEase, founded by Ding Li in 1997 at number 7, Ellie Mae, founded by Sig Anderman in 1997, Amazon.com, founded in 1995 by Jeff Bezos at number 9, and Arista Networks, originally co-founded in 1982 as Sun Microsystems by Andy Bechtolsheim at number 10. So how do these great success stories fit into your vision of where your business is headed? Whether you are going from a local shop to a regional chain, or from a national brand to an international household name, the answer will always be the same. In order to take the leap from entrepreneur to enterprise, you must be willing to tear the pieces of your business apart and reconstruct them at a higher level that drives your growth. It doesn't matter whether you are in the 6 figures and scaling to 7, or 7 figures and scaling to 8 or even 9. You must be willing to get out of your comfort zone and jump while at each level. The good news is that there is always a safety net under the trapeze. And when it comes to scaling, this book will serve as part of your safety net to ensure you manage falls and setbacks, receive all the support you need, and get right back on the trapeze. Sure, it is scary, but the strategies I provide in this book will help you separate real fears from imagined ones, assess them carefully, and ultimately choose growth over staying still. Time to fly. My intent with Scale or Fail is to help business owners and entrepreneurs like you get past the mental and strategic pitfalls that cause revenue bottlenecks and expansion headaches, stunting financial and personal growth. Applying my formula with diligence has led to breakthroughs every day for so many of my clients, from neighborhood sole proprietors to CEOs of nationally known brand name corporations. In the chapters that follow, I will share with you my signature roadmap of scaling called the Scale It Method, through which I outline how you can multiply your growth across a variety of assets, including retaining and recruiting the best talent, creating a collaborative, efficient, and satisfying workplace environment, developing new products and services, and/or building your core customer base, and producing an ever-flowing stream of cash flow with consistent profits. In addition, I show you how you can build a business that has deeper meaning for you and one that can impact the world in a positive way. Let me emphasize one crucial point. Doubling your business does not mean working doubly hard with your sweat equity. Instead, it is about leveraging your team's talents and your own intellectual and leadership capital to successfully apply one or more of the 16 scalable strategies presented. Visual tools, checklists, and spreadsheets illustrate these discussions, and as a bonus, you will find them continually updated on the following website. Go to www.scaleorfail.com/bonus. The five components of scale. There are five components that are central in scaling your company. Each of these five levels of the scale it method are described with exact steps to follow and are highlighted with powerful stories of the amazing clients I've had the honor to know and work with over the years. Let's go over them. S-C-A-L-E. S, strategic vision. Knowing where you are headed is crucial in order to figure out how to get there. Yet most business owners don't have a clear destination in mind, and, as you might imagine, this is a big reason why they flail about instead of remaining steadily on course. Your strategic vision, or big picture vision as I call it, is your personal yellow brick road to the Emerald City. It is the inspiration that keeps you determined and moving forward, regardless of the obligatory rejections and brick walls you will face. Creating the right big picture vision is the key to being able to successfully scale your business. C, cash flow. Think of cash flow as the life force of your company. It ensures you are breathing and pumping blood to the core systems of your business so they will thrive and grow. You must build a revenue-driven business that creates cash for your business on a daily basis. Applying the cash flow practices discussed in this book will give you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.